Firmware update 8.0, the very, very long-awaited update to the autopilot systems. We are on 8.0 version 2.36.108 release. Let's go through the release notes, and then I will go through each feature one by one. Update succeeded. What is new in this update? Release 8.0 introduces the biggest refresh to the touchscreen user interface since the launch of the Model S. The media player has been completely redesigned, making it easier for you to take advantage of existing selection of audio entertainment available. The maps also feature an expanded on-screen area for enhanced visibility. Trip Planner contains significant upgrades so that you can drive longer trips more confidently. Finally, Autopilot has been enhanced with over 200 changes that allow more comfortable driving experience. We got a preview of the... Whoa, check that out. One thing I can tell you immediately is that Tesla has increased the response time of the touchscreen. That would have been considerably more laggy on the old software. I'll get to that in a minute. But there's a preview of the new media app. The touchscreen user interface has been redesigned to give you a larger map that is uncluttered by controls. The status bar and application icons at the top of the touchscreen will fade when the vehicle is driving. They will reappear with a tap or when the vehicle is parked. When selected, the maps and the camera app will now always appear on the top half of the touchscreen, whereas other apps will appear on the bottom half. You can still rearrange them as desired. Modern Media Player. The media player has been redesigned to put popular content in your favorite stations front and center. Each search is simpler to use and more powerful, covering streaming radio, live stations, and podcasts to help you quickly find what you're looking for. Note, Slacker Music is now streaming personal radio. Now Playing View. The new Now Playing View is more useful and flexible, allowing you to browse your favorite or recently listened to content without having to switch screens. The new Browse View, simpler navigation. The new Browse View places saved favorites at the top of for easy access. It also highlights popular content such as top music, comedy, news on streaming personal radio, and podcasts and popular radio stations from around the world on TuneIn. Improved search. Search is now simpler to access and more powerful. You can search TuneIn as well as streaming personal radio. Filters on results help you quickly find what you're looking for. You can also use voice commands to initiate any search. TuneIn. TuneIn now showcases a selection of popular podcasts, as well as music and talk stations. Discover top content by genre from your local area or from around the world. Podcast fans will find it easier to keep up with their regular podcasts and discover new ones. The podcast view now includes a description and a clearly laid out list of episodes. You can also add a podcast that you listen to regularly to favorites for easy access. Streaming personal radio. Streaming personal radio has been redesigned to let you start listening to high-quality audio entertainment right away. Select from popular stations or saved favorites. You can easily find popular music, news, comedy, and sports stations, as well as discover new stations by genre. With this release, we are also introducing DJ Series, DJ-curated programs that are an entertainment way to discover new music and learn more about your favorite artist. What music inspired them and how their biggest hits came to be. Radio. Radio has been updated with a clean, modern look. Redesigned for greater ease of use, you can now access more than 6 radio presets on the Now Playing View. Tap again on the radio to view a full list of your favorite radio stations. Sirius XM subscribers can now browse channels more easily, find content by genre using new channel guide available below radio favorites. USB. With this release, we've made it easier for you to browse your USB music collection. Find songs at a glance with ample space to view titles and song details. Listening to favorites with steering wheel controls. You can now listen to your favorites using the left steering wheel buttons. Play through your favorites. You can loop through all your favorites across sources via long press of the steering wheel button. Favorite tiles at the bottom of the now playing view will shift as you navigate through your favorites. Listen to radio favorites. You can advance through all your radio favorites more quickly with short taps of the steering wheel button. Maps improvements. Maps have been redesigned to give you the largest map possible. Controls now hide to appear intelligently or for an uncluttered map view while you drive. Controls are visible when the car is parked, so you can make any adjustment before you start driving. They will hide once you start your drive, but you can easily recall them with a single tap of the touchscreen. Maps will also maintain position at the top of your touchscreen when you open another app, besides the camera app, so you will always have a clear view of the roads around you. You can still rearrange them as desired. Searching for a location. You can now specify a destination or a location with a single tap. Simply tap on the navigate button and select from the list of places. Enter address or search for a business or a point of interest. Or better yet, search using voice commands. Smart map zooming. Get the right amount of detail on your map display even when you're not using navigation. Tracking is enabled. The map will now scale automatically to display the appropriate area around your car. Example, zoomed in appropriately so you can see enough detail for the area you are driving in. Chargers list. To view the available chargers in a region on the map, tap the lightning bolt button. A list of chargers will appear, and the locations of each of these chargers will be indicated with corresponding pins on the map. To view chargers in another location, tap Cancel at the bottom of the chargers list. Move the map to the area of interest and tap on the lightning bolt button again. Navigation improvements. Swipe to navigate home or work. With this release, it is now much easier to navigate to home or work. In the morning, just swipe down on the navigation button in the Maps app and navigation will automatically begin towards work. Similarly, when you are away from home, swipe down on the nav button and it will automatically route you for home. This feature requires that an address be set for home and work in your places list. Avoid tolls and ferries option. Navigate now has the option to allow you to avoid tolls and ferries. These settings can be found in Controls, Settings, Apps, Maps, and Navigation. The navigation routes may still include tolls and ferries if there are no reasonable routes without tolls or ferries. Improved turn list. Turn list order. Guidance has been reordered to present the distance to the maneuver first, so it's more intuitive. Round-trip energy estimate is now easier to find. It will always appear at the bottom of the turn list. Scroll to the bottom of the turn list if you'd like to find this information at the start of your trip. You now have the option to enable display this value via setting controls, setting apps, maps, navigation. When enabled, this value will always appear at the bottom of the turn list. Just scroll there if you'd like to find this information at the start of your trip. Traffic-based routing enhancement. You can now specify the maximum time savings before the navigation system reroutes based on traffic. This setting can be found in Control Settings, Apps, Maps, and Navigation. Note, traffic-based commute advice is activated by this same setting. Trip Planner Improvements. Trip Planner has been redesigned to provide a clearer guidance before you start your trip. After calculating all the superchargers where you will need to charge for your trip, Trip Planner will first zoom out and display your route with all the supercharger stops, as in previous releases. With this release, Trip Planner will now pause to give you sufficient time to review before you embark on your trip. Navigation guidance to the first supercharger will start automatically. If you start driving when you tap on the Show Directions button, once you've started your trip, Trip Planner now has two view options to allow you to view either the current leg of your trip or the overall route. Voice command improvements. Voice command improvements are now easier to use. More accurate content matching. Your voice commands for calling a contact is now more accurate. Easier to initiate. Press the top right steering wheel button just once to initiate a voice command. Press again to indicate that you are done. Clear feedback. A transcript will now appear on the instrument panel that reflects what the system heard, so you can tell right away how you are understood. Clear guidance. Tips will appear to remind you that what voice commands are available. Quicker response. When using voice commands to call a contact, if there is only one match, dialing will begin automatically. You can override this by pressing the steering wheel button. If there are multiple phone numbers for a contact, you can view the options in the instrument panel and select the right number to call via the steering wheel controls. Access to your contacts and recent calls have been moved to the lower right steering wheel button. Just press once and scroll to the appropriate menu item. Trip meters. Your trip meters have been improved to give you flexibility to track and monitor your different trips. Trip meters can now be named for quick reference. Press and hold to edit. You can now choose which trip meter to display in the instrument panel. This can be found in Controls and Trips. Autopilot improvements. With this release, we are further ensuring that drivers remain engaged in driving while using autosteer, including keeping their hands on the wheel and responding to autopilot prompts. If the drivers leave hands off the wheel or ignore autopilot prompts, autosteer will disengage and remain unavailable for the duration of the drive. Autosteer will be available again only after the car has been put into park. Redesigned autopilot indicators. Autopilot indicators have been redesigned to more clearly indicate when traffic-aware cruise control or autosteer beta are available or enabled. Traffic-aware cruise control and autosteer are available but not active. The set speed would be 65 miles per hour when traffic-aware cruise control or autosteer is engaged. Traffic-aware cruise control and autosteer are active. The set speed for autosteer is 65. Traffic-aware cruise control is available, but autosteer is unavailable. Additional improvements. Previously, a failed activation of autosteer would enable cruise. With this release, it will no longer do so. Autopilot has been tuned to be more responsive and smoother in stop-and-go traffic. Cars on the instrument panel are now angled, clearly indicate where nearby vehicles are heading. In addition to displaying the vehicle immediately in front of you, Autopilot now uses radar detection to display the second car ahead of you as well. When necessary, Autopilot may respond to rapid braking of this car. While you drive, Autopilot now captures a continuous picture of the world through radar. When combined with data from other vehicles in the fleet, this will enable a significant enhancement to emergency braking capabilities in future releases. More improvements. Climate control. Cabin overheat protection allows you to maintain cabin temperatures at a safer level. A feature that is possible with electric vehicles only. When this feature is active, the climate control system will prevent the cabin from reaching extremely high temperatures for a period of up to 12 hours after you exit the vehicle. Air conditioning will attempt to ensure cabin temperature does not exceed 105 degrees Fahrenheit or 40 degrees Celsius. Cabin overheat protection is on by default. You can disable this feature at the controls, settings, vehicle, cabin overheat. Note, cabin overheat protection does not operate or stops operating when the energy remaining in the battery is 20% or less. There is now consistent airflow for a given fan speed across different climate control modes. Example, fresh air and recirculated air. Climate control now accounts for solar heating to maintain consistent temperature in the cabin. It calculates cooling and heating needs based on the angle of the sun at your car's location. Displays. For passenger comfort, the displays will stay active at the end of the drive after a driver has left the car. Passengers can set the temperature, use maps, play music, without the driver being present. The displays will stay on for as long as the passenger is in front seat, stays in the car, and continues to interact with the screen. Homelink. Homelink icon intelligently displays when your car is within range of your garage, and an audio tone will sound. Improved regenerative braking. We have improved regenerative braking on the standard regen level. Your car will decelerate slightly more to recapture more energy. And that is it for the release notes. Next up, I will be going through and actually going through and displaying each different set of features on the car and interacting with them.
Smile, cheese.